Welcome to the session, High Performance Concrete. Myself, Mr. Chetan G. Konapure, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Vulcan Institute of Technology. Now, these are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, student will be able to understand the silent features of high performance concrete, mixtures of high performance concrete. Now, the regular concrete or conventional concrete, we know that it is a mixture of ingredients. And in earlier session, we have seen high strength concrete. The one parameter was there, that is the strength, which was enhanced in the high strength concrete. Now, the term high performance concrete means the performance means what? What are the performance criteria? So, high performance concrete is used to refer the concrete for a required performance for majority of the construction application. Means basically, based on the industrial requirement and the construction applications, the performance level for different parameters and properties can be enhanced, and that concrete is called as high performance concrete. Now, high performance concrete is also high strength concrete, but it has a few more qualities. Now, what are the performance criteria? What are these qualities which can be enhanced? For example, high workability, high strength. Means workability and strength can be enhanced. So that is a regular thing in the concrete. But what are the other performance levels? Next thing is high density, low permeability, resistance to chemical attack, resistance to sulfate attack. All these things actually reveals more durable concrete or a high durable concrete. So durability of the concrete with high strength and with other enhanced properties is basically high performance concrete. How that can be achieved? What is the theme in that achieving of high performance concrete? So densification and strengthening of the transition zone, that will give us some enhanced desirable properties, and that these properties can be improved by this theme of densification and strengthening of transition zone. Now, what is transition zone? Transition zone is the coating on the aggregate, maybe fine aggregate or a coarse aggregate, coating of the cement paste surrounding to these aggregates. So the stresses are transferred from matrix cement paste to the aggregates. That zone is called as the transition zone. Now let us see this is a schematic diagram which explains the approaches for production of HPC. How the high performance concrete can be produced? Basic theme is all parameters like workability, strength, density are with high requirements. But the most important thing is durability. High durability is also expected. Especially durability is the key parameter in the HPC. Now there is one approach, that is reducing the capillary pores we can achieve. Second way is we can bind the sites to prevent the transportation of chloride ions. So these two approaches are useful for production of HPC. Now these capillary pores are the sources through which the durability of the concrete may affect. And second thing is the chloride ions that will also affect the durability of the concrete. So both the things can be controlled in HPC to get the high performance concrete, high durability concrete. How these capillary pores can be reduced? First is we can go for reduced water binder ratio, for very low water cement ratio for we need admixture. Next is use of fine fillers, silica fume we can use, good compaction, improved curing. By these four features, we can reduce the capillary pores. And next is how we can prevent the transportation of chloride ions. That is by binding the sites for chloride ions, and for that we can use supplementary cementitious material, SCM. So supplementary cementitious material are ground granulated blast furnace slag, fly ash, metacoline, rice husk, and blends ash. Now these features are increasing the physical resistance of the concrete, means all the mechanical properties can be increased. And by using these supplementary cementitious material, the concrete can be made durable. So increased physical resistance means mechanical properties, maybe compressive strength, flexural strength, tensile strength that can be increased, and by using supplementary cementitious material, durability of concrete can be enhanced. Now, the first feature, silent feature, use of water. Now, for mixing purpose, water is used. Now, the fundamental step in HPC is low water cement ratio, or reducing the quantity of water in the concrete. So, reducing the quantity of water means whatever water is required for hydration process that is actually used, and rest of the quantity of water is basically required for workability. So, if we go for a lower water cement ratio, probably we will get more dense concrete, more durable concrete. That is the one thing. Now, next is use of mineral admixture. This is the second theme. Now, fine materials, the fillers which are having a particle size less than cement, those fillers we can add into the concrete. Why these are required? As I have explained in the schematic diagram in earlier slide, to reduce the capillary pores, we have to use the filler material, especially silica fume. So, the particle size of silica fume is 100th size of the particle size of cement. So, this can reduce the capillary pores, those, and most important thing is silica fume improves the quality of transition zone. Now, the transition zone is actually the weak portion, weak zone in the concrete. So, effective stress transfer is possible through this transition zone. If that is improved, your durability concrete will increase. Next is supplementary cementitious material. Now, we can use best quality fly ash, ground granulated blast furnace slag that can be used. Why it is used? So, the chloride ions transportation can be prevented, and we can get better durability. Now, the chemical admixture, the third silent feature is, so use of appropriate superplasticizer. This will facilitate to use a reduced amount of water, which will reduce the water demand. And most important thing is chemical admixture is whether that chemical admixture is compatible to the material or ingredient which is used for the concrete, maybe aggregate, fine aggregate, and your cement, type of cement. So, compatibility of the chemical admixture shall be checked, and the optimum dosage of superplasticizer for the particular water cement ratio, quantity of water, dosage shall be designed. Now, fourth important feature is aggregates for high performance concrete. Now, basically, the in normal concrete, the strength of aggregate plays important role. In case of HPC, majority of the strength of the concrete volume can be taken by this volume of the aggregate. So, strength of the aggregate is also important parameter. Next thing is, now the load or stresses which is coming on the concrete sections in which HPC is used, that these stresses from cement paste to aggregate, it must transfer. And that is by means of only bond between aggregate and cement paste. Now, your bond between aggregate and cement must be proper and strong. So, as your bond between the aggregate and cement paste is good or strong, which ensures the significant transfer of stress across transition zone. So, bond is also important. For that, your aggregate must be of good quality. Now, next thing is, as low water cement ratio is used for HPC, sometimes strength of cement paste is greater than the strength of the aggregate. But what is the aggregate size used for HPC? This is the question for all of you students. So, just write down the aggregate size for the HPC. Pause the video. Now, for aggregate size for HPC, in various authors, if the strength of the concrete is up to 100 MPa, the maximum size of aggregate is 20 mm. And if the strength is more than 100 MPa, maximum size may be in between 12 to 10 mm. But practically, in several trials for the materials which is available, for that 12 mm, 10 mm is the practically proved aggregate size for HPC. Now, the shape of aggregate must be cubic. so which gives a proper transition zone, and crushed aggregate shall be used. Now, in many instances, strength of aggregate is important, because if aggregates are cut for a particular load, so the strength at that cut, that failure, governs the compressive strength of HPC. More flaky aggregate or elongated aggregate decreases the workability and strength. Now, these are the typical mixtures for HPC. So, I have calculated the proportions here. The cement and fly ash, the both cementitious material, if you consider one, your fine aggregate is 1.82. Then, coarse aggregate is 1.82. Fine aggregate is 1.15. And chemical admixture water reducer is used, that is of 1.75%. Now, we can see here two mixes which were shown in earlier table. In first mix, I have calculated and shown on that table itself. Now, second mix, in which water cement ratio is 0.37 and fine aggregate is 1.651, coarse aggregate 2.22. Now, we can see here the superplasticizer dose. Here, you can see 11.25 liter per meter cube. This dose is 2.6% of weight of cement. Now, water used in first mix is 195 kg per meter cube. Water in mix 2 is 165 kg per meter cube. So, in second mix, quantity of water is less. That's why superplasticizer dosage is more. These are the references for this session. Thank you.